About here's in a big win against Federal Way last night.
First time in the state finals is Kingma, Todd, Massengale, O'Keefe, Wischko as we tip, and Cantwell to run it down. Wilson, Everett, Boyce, Tyler, and the big man, of course, Joshua Smith. You would expect so in a state title game. Nice dish inside, and Wilson converts. As we said, Smith third in the tournament in assists.
Absolutely.
Wilson to Smith. Oh! They're winning 12-8. They've taken the lead in our poll question. Again, Texas 95323. Who's going to win tonight, A or B? A nice pass by Wilson and the good hands. We see it.
To the mid-post area, there's a Josh Smith, and you see him turn and look opposite, find the cutter along the baseline and delivers a nice pass. Lay it up off the glass. So two examples of the two team stars making the guys around them better.
Wilson from behind the arc. He had 12 last night. His first three ball gives Kenwood the lead at 15-14.
And Alec Wilson's a good outside shooter, and he's one of the guys they're not going to be able to lay off and trying to give help on the post to Smith.
Another air ball, his third air ball the first half here. Skylar Ganger in the game for the Conquerors, along with Taylor Jones, the sophomore, number 13, 6'6". Wilson inside to him.
Double-teaming Smith everywhere he goes on the court.
Wilson, another three-point attempt. That one is good. He's 2 for 2, and you're right. He can shoot it.
He can shoot it. He can play.
Got the size advantage over Everett. Uses it right there. Smith trying to get it to Wilson, cutting to the hoop. Knocked out of bounds. It'll stay Conquerors basketball. Wilson inside to Smith. He's got two on him, but it doesn't matter.
That is another way of making Jackson play them honestly on the defensive end.
Well, look at Wilson gets lost on the double team, and Smith's able to find him. Smith to Wilson does a nice job going up with the offhand, and Kentwood stretches their lead to 7. Welcome back to the T-Dome for the WIAA 4A Boys Championship game. Kentwood on top of Jackson, 37-29, outscoring the Timberwolves by 10 there in the second quarter. Again, welcome to the T-Dome. It's Brad Adam and
Frank. That's their game. That's when they're at their best.
Wilson, who had 10 points in the first half, misses his first shot here in the third quarter.
Thomas Jackson just ran right by him.
The student body on their feet.
He'll be the biggest guy on the floor. But you put him on the floor now where everybody's got to play him honestly, and he's playing with four other guys that can play, playing his position, and now all of a sudden he's going to be even more effective. And you see his skill set. He has the ability to make guys around him better. So, you put him on the floor with four other guys that are good players, and he gets even better, I think.
And there he is inside, and easy's in, averaging almost 15 rebounds a game this tournament, which leads the tournament.
Well, that's a deep three.
Whoa, Tyler, feeling it. Misses another free throw. He's got 11 points. The lead is now 10. Another reaching foul there on King FSN. A night of champions in the 4A division from the T-Dome. Smith just 1 for 4 from the line tonight.
You take a look. Stevens looks ahead. Finds Smith underneath, getting ready to get it uncontested.
And here comes a full court pressure again, but Wilson and Kentwood able to break it, and Massengale the foul, 1-1. Wilson's knocked down a couple triples, his first time at the free throw line, and gets it to go. FSN and FSN HD is wall-to-wall coverage, tips off this Wednesday night.
Sure that they feel confident that they can win this one.
Tyler with the good hands and steal, and Wilson's got it out in front for Kentwood. Can't remember the girls from Kentwood won the title last year. So those fans know a little bit about celebrating and cutting down nets. Massengale having to foul Wilson right there. And the fans.
With 51.4 seconds to go.
Got the first one.
And pulls it back out, and they use up a little more clock. And this time Wilson goes to the line and knocks them both down.
He's got 14 points. The lead is now 11. And they will be your 2009-2010 state champions of the 4A division. And there they go.
I got a feeling that tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. I feel it. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good night. That tonight's gonna be a good, good night. Tonight's the night. Let's live it up. I got my money. Let's spin it up. Go out and smash it. Like, oh my God. Jump out that sofa. Let's kick it off.
A look at Robinson Hall here on the campus of Samford University in Birmingham, Alabama. Three of those players ticketed to play for Division I schools. And next year, the T-Mobile starting lineup brought by the Texas. On the rebound, Tyler gets it. Nice bounce pass to a running teammate that's put in by Alec Wilson.
Kentwood does a nice job executing in the open court. They're very well coached. They're very smart. And here they have an opportunity. Nice bounce pass and a finish. When you go into the glass, use the backboard. Use the glass.
Is up to 18 again. Wilson knocks down a three.
Welcome into the Old Spice High School Showcase presented by the United States Marine Corps. We're at Kentwood High School in Covington, Washington, and our matchup tonight, Jefferson High taking on Kent.
Ben Allen and the UCLA Bruins will get next year.
All right, our Nike starting lineups, Antoine Hosley, BJ Jones, Terrence Jones, Steven Madison, Bears Watch, a good shooter, and Noah Kone. Meanwhile, for Kentwood, it'll be Mikel Everett, Alec Wilson, Trey Tyler, Jason Boyce, and Josh Smith. Kentwood wins the point blank shot right there. And Roundtree couldn't get it to go. It's Kentwood into the front court. It has been a tight one here in Covington, Washington. Oh, and a corner three, a biggie from Alec Wilson.